At some point, everyone learns that a CPU has a variable number of cores inside, and that number influences your processor's performance. Usually right after, people then want to know how many cores their CPU has. The good news is, figuring that out is extremely easy in Windows. In both Windows 10 and 11, just tap the Windows key on your keyboard or click on the Start Menu button, then begin typing the word System. The top match should be System or System Information. Either will work, so hit the Enter key or click on that result, and a window will appear that lists your hardware information, including the name of your processor and the number of cores that it has. Alternatively, you can press Control-Shift-Escape on your keyboard to bring up the Task Manager window. In the upper right of the Performance tab, you'll see the name of your processor and the number of cores that it has. You'll also see a graph showing your CPU's utilization in real time. Underneath the graph are more detailed stats like the base clock speed, cores, and logical processors, also more commonly known as threads. That's all you have to do to find out your core count. However, the story doesn't actually stop there if you're trying to figure out how powerful your CPU is. Core count is just one clue about CPU performance. Processor frequency, also known as clock speed, multi-threading, the generation of the chip, the type of CPU, whether that's desktop or mobile, and software optimization also play a role. You can look up the raw specs of your processor online really easily, like on Intel's Arc website or AMD's processor specification website, but honestly, the easier way to tell how well your CPU stacks up is to simply look up benchmark results for the things you do regularly, whether that's office work, gaming, video coding, etc., etc. Generally, the newer the processor, the more efficient and more powerful it is, but not all generations make huge leaps in performance over previous ones. Looking up actual test results tells you concretely the gap between generations. The same applies to competing CPUs from the same time period. You might expect a top-tier part with fewer cores to underperform a rival maker's best chip, but that's not necessarily the case. Sometimes they end up being in the same ballpark, making the choice more about cost, availability, and the specific programs and games you'll be spending time in. Same goes for thread count or a CPU's capacity to handle multiple processes at the same time. CPUs with higher thread counts are just better multitaskers, and that only matters when you regularly do multi-threaded work. And even when that's the case, still be aware that the generation of your chip still plays a bigger role in its performance. The short of it is, core count isn't everything, nor thread count, nor even the age of those cores and threads. It's more nuanced than that. More importantly, if you have no complaints about your PC when you're using it, then you don't need to upgrade or make any changes at all. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you want to know more about CPU performance and how specific processors stack up, be sure to subscribe to our channel. Also, if this video is helpful to you, give it a like. Otherwise, I'll catch you in the next one.